G'day everyone. I'm going to do a, for me this will probably be one of the most challenging rides I'm about to do. We're on a walking hiking trail in the middle of the forest with lots of varied terrain, lots of steep hills both up and down, lots of rocks. I'm going to have to actually drive up some stairs at some point. So I did the lowering link on the bike. And I lowered the seat as well, so at least I can get my feet down, not completely flat-footed, but at least I can touch the ground on both feet now. So we're going to do this footage, and it'll certainly be a test for myself. Lots of riding on the clutch and throttle input will be really important, so let's see how we do. Coming up to a really steep hill right off the start, but I'm going to have to go down. So the ground is a little wet today, so hopefully we have some good traction. I'll have to put the weight further back. Now that steep hill, so I'm gonna a little bit of slide out there. Good overall. It's a pretty little trail. We go right along the lake here. this wood back here, roots included, but any of these man-made platforms are extremely slippery. Just wiped her out on that tree. Today, guys, to be doing this one. These roots are just deadly. Oh. This is just beyond slippery here. If I was to let the clutch out, the bike would slide right off. Whew. Yeah, a little haywire, boys. I'll get around this log and we'll start over. Assess what's going on here. See how slippery the wood is. Be right back. All right, guys, made it up the stairs, but not what I would call smooth or technical in any stretch. Anyways, it's starting to rain pretty good. I got to get out of here, so we're going to keep going. I can't go up these stairs either. I got to cut through the bush here. I got a little log to jump over. We'll see how sketchy this is going to be. Hopefully we can do it a little better. Obviously, there was a rock in there that I did not see. Thank God for brush guards. The rock was just before the log. This is like very thick cover there. Everything is so wet. Everything is soaking wet. Whew. Shit show, boys. Oh, shit show. All right, guys. Messed up on that one too. Didn't want to take the bridge. Too slippery. Ended up going through a mud hole. Got stuck, of course. Going only 2.5 miles. Feels like about 200. Anyways, I gotta continue on our journey. you can see, even with the lowering kit and the sheet saved down, I still have a hard time on really technical stuff, and given my skill level, that would be the most I'd ever want to tackle, I think, at this point. But my riding continues to improve. That wasn't an indication. But we'll show you some other trails that are still fairly tough that I can handle pretty good. So the only other thing I mentioned in my first video was the fuel range. Now that the bike is broken in, you can go 40 miles on a tank. You wouldn't want to go much more than 40, but if you're just driving tight technical trails, sometimes into second or third, without being on the throttle all day long, you can get 40 out of it. And other than that, everything remains the same. I'm still real happy with the bike. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed this. We'll talk soon.